Raise your hand. How many people here, including you guys, what they call these people, Zoomers? Zoomers? Yeah. In the camera? How many people here have either heard me before or this is your first time? Go ahead, raise your hand. Neither one, huh? Neither one of the above. Well, okay. As he said, my name is Steve Sapato, and what he was talking about was I run a thing here in Tampa called Speaker Talks, competition for TEDx, and I do it every 6 months to give people the opportunity to get on stage and give their best performance so that they can showcase what they do. And people say, well, why do you do this? How did you get into that? And that's why I'm here today. Are you with me? How many people here absolutely love what they do? Yeah, absolutely. Everybody in here does, because that's why we're here. Do you know that? That's why we're here, because we love what we do. And it's important for you to understand something. And that is, I love what I do too. So my first question is, how many people in the room and on the Zoom? Hey, did you see that? Rhyme. I could do rap, Max, couldn't I? In the room or on the Zoom, how many of you, ready? Here's the question. Want for somebody else to be more successful than you? See, in the room, half the hands went up. The other half are like, heck no, man. Right? It's all about me. Isn't that what we learned? It's all about me. But here's what I want you to understand. If you have somebody that you want to be more successful than yourself, join me on stage. And when I say that, I mean, that's why I got into this business. I want you to be more successful than me, and I will work my heart out to get you there. It's really important to understand that most of us, was it Thoreau that said we live lives of quiet desperation? Anybody know, was that Thoreau? This is yes, this is no, this is I have no clue. Okay, so nobody knows, we'll take it as Thoreau. That's what I want you to understand. We live lives of quiet desperation. But why do we do that? Why do so many people do that? You four speakers up here, you're going to hear more speakers that talk about the frustration we have as people, as individuals, how we want to grow, how we want to become. And that's why I do what I do. I get with people, and I help them become better speakers, better presenters, better business people. I help them follow their dreams. How many people here have a dream? Okay, let me ask you a question. When we talk about having a dream, okay, how many people here would love to achieve that dream in the next 12 to 24 months? Yep, most everybody. When you're on Zoom, you want to achieve that dream, it's vital that you say yes. Vital that you say yes, because otherwise you're going to live that life of quiet desperation. When we talk about what it takes to succeed, you have to have a drive, you have to have a passion. And here's what I'm going to ask you first. How many people here have a specific goal in their mind that they want to achieve in the next 12 to 24 months? A specific goal. How many of them have that written down? Okay. Excellent. Most everybody in this room, how about the Zoom? You have it written down, because one thing that people in this room know is that if you write your dream down, you're more likely to achieve it. Everybody with me on that? If you write, don't ask me why that is, but you write it down, then you put a plan with it, and then you go. It's success, and that's what we're after. We're after this huge success. So I want to help people be more successful. Who wants to be more successful? Okay, so we get most people want to be more successful. The question is, how do we do that? Okay, and that's by establishing ourselves in what we want to achieve. So here's the thing I want you to do. Pull out that piece of paper that you've probably been jotting a few notes on. I want you to write down 5 goals you would love to achieve in the next 12 to 24 months. 5 things. It should take you about 30 seconds because, well, no, I take it back. For the Zoom people, it might take you forever. Because nobody's asked you to do that before. Nobody said, let me help you achieve your dreams. Nobody said, what dreams do you have? I'll tell you a quick story. My second marriage, well, a long time ago. Second marriage. When we got married, we said, hey, we want to go to Hawaii. Everybody good with that? Want to go to Hawaii? Yes. 12 years later, we were still saying, hey, we want to go to Hawaii. A friend of mine walked in. Matter of fact, he just passed away from COVID this past week. But he walked in, he sat down with my wife and I. He said, where do you guys want to go? We said, we want to go to Hawaii. They said, why haven't you gone? We said, it costs too much. He said, come on, you guys can afford to go to Hawaii. I went, no, honest, we can't. He went, how can that be? How much does it cost? What was my answer? That was my answer. I don't know. He said, well, how do you know you can't afford to go if you don't know how much it costs? I go, I'm from Moline, Illinois, just so you know. Right? And all I knew was, it costs too much. Is that what you say to yourself? I can't achieve this. I can't do that. Why not? Somebody said I couldn't. So he made us sit down. He made us make a phone call. We found out it cost $2,500 to go to Hawaii 20 years ago with all the trimmings and all the stuff we wanted. He said, well, then it's only $2,500. I went, yeah. He went, well, you don't have that? I went, no. He said, well, give me half now and get the next half next year. No. He said, you don't have $1,200, Steve? No, I don't. He said, well, okay, then let's start the process. It's only $100 a month. I went, geez, if it's only $100 a month, I'd own a big screen TV. You see, I didn't have a focus on going to Hawaii. I had a focus on now. How about you? You're focusing on now? If you have a dream or a goal and you've got it in front of you, it's important, okay? It's important that you keep it in front of you. How many people here? Matter of fact, I'll give a $50 gift certificate to somebody who has their dream or their goal in their wallet or in their purse and can pull it out and produce it for me right now. $50 gift certificate. Come here, young lady. Come here, you just come up the edge of the stage. I just want to see it. I want to see your dreams and goals. Now, here's somebody who says they have it with them. Oh. Wow. And she does. Right? Awesome. Now, she's the only one. Now, Michelle, I want you to make sure you write to me and say, hey, you owe me. And I will get you a gift certificate. And that gift certificate will be to wherever you want it to go. Okay? I hate the people who say, I'm going to give you a gift certificate. And then they say, it's $50 off my program. Shut up. Get away. Right? But what I want you to understand is, when he said it's $100 a month, I said, I can't afford $100 a month. What? He said, how can that be? I went, just don't have it. He said, do you know how much that is per day? And I broke it down, and it was $3.33 a day. For $3.33 a day, I could go to Hawaii in 2 years. And he had us put together the plan that one of us would stop drinking a cup of coffee that cost $3 or $4 that day. And we went to Hawaii actually 2 years and 4 months later. Wow, why? Because we had the focus. We had the focus. You're lacking the focus to achieve your dreams. Why? First of all, let's talk about something. Who here has an outrageous goal for the next 12 to 24 months? Who wants to share that with me? One outrageous goal that you want to share? Oh, she does, I like her. She's 5. She probably wants more toys. All right? Nobody raised their hand. Isn't that interesting? Nobody raised their hand that says, I have an outrageous goal. First of all, what's an outrageous goal? Let me tell you. Let me share with you. An outrageous goal for me a few years ago, 10 years ago, was to make $10,000 a month. Now, I come from Moline, Illinois. In Moline, Illinois, that's John Deere country. If you don't work for John Deere, you work for one of the little companies that supplies John Deere. Average income, $55,000 a year, right? So making $10,000 a month was like, oh my gosh, let's do that. How do I make $10,000 a month? Outrageous goal. Guess what I think of that goal today? No big deal. Whoopie doopie, right? $10,000 a month is only $120,000 a year, only. Now, with some people back in Moline, Illinois, probably still are dying to make $10,000 a month. What's my outrageous goal now? $100,000 a month. 100 people go, $100,000 a month. I go, that's only $1.2 million a year. Only. Well, for people like Bill Walsh and the people he clicks around with, that's no big deal. They make that every year. They're hoping to make $10 million this year, $20 million. But for a lot of us, that's an outrageous goal. How would you like me to help you achieve that outrageous goal that you've got in your head or maybe written down on your piece of paper? Would you like that?
Yes.
Why haven't we already achieved it? Most of the time, it's because the same reason we didn't share it, somebody's going to say, that's outrageous. That's why we call it an outrageous goal. They'll also say, that's stupid, that's not realistic, that's not achievable. Who said it wasn't? Other people are making that. Other people are achieving that. Now, I put it in monetary terms, but you know what? It might not be monetary. Maybe you want to own the largest charity group to give away the most money. Whatever your outrageous goal is, should be achievable. But we have been taught, we have been programmed to run away from achieving that dream. We're afraid people will criticize us. We're afraid people will downgrade us. We're afraid they're going to say something bad. You know, they say public speaking is the number one or number two greatest fear of the humans. I don't know about rabbits. Right? But why would it be even in the top 10? You know why it's in the top 10, fear of speaking in public? Because we're afraid of criticism. Think about it. What's one of the, how many times have you walked down the street and you stumble and you almost fall, right? First thing you do is you look back to see what tripped you. Usually what do you find? Nothing. There's nothing there. I just got to be spastic and I tripped over something. But what's the second thing you do after you make that trip?
Look around.
See who watched you.
Look around. Who saw me looking stupid? Right? We're afraid of looking stupid. About 2 years ago, I guess it was. It was pre-COVID, right? I lose a year in there. Anybody else, you lose that year in there? I think it was 2 years ago. I made a video at my home, posted it online, and I came to do a little video with no pants on. Now people go, no pants on, because I started off with, oh my gosh, I forgot my pants, right? And then I did the video. Here's what's curious. How many people would find that embarrassing to be standing here in just your underwear? Anybody? Right. Here's what I find more curious. First of all, in men's underwear, our pants or our underwear is usually longer than the gym shorts we used to wear. For women, your underwear covers more than your bathing suit ever will. Am I right? Ladies, am I right? Your bathing suit is like, right? And your underwear is real nice, lacy things covering a lot more territory. And yet we're afraid to walk in front of people in our underwear. I had the guts the other day. It was dark. 9 o'clock at night. My wife called. She was out of town. She said, did you get the mail? I said, I'll go get it now. I walked out, got the mail. When I came back, she said, did you go get the mail in your underwear?
Yeah.
I went, yeah. She says, only you. I go, no, it's probably everybody. We just can't tell. Men's underwear comes down to here. Right? Nobody's going to care if you're in your underwear. Answer the door in your underwear, unless you're a lady. Guys, nobody goes, oh, you're in your underwear. We don't know. So here's my question to you. What is achieving your dreams worth to you? How much is achieving your dreams worth to you? Worth $50? Worth $500? Worth $5,000? Who says achieving my dreams is worth $5,000 or $10,000? Guess what? Only three hands went up in this crowd. In this crowd. Why is that? Because we're afraid somebody's going to ask us for it. If you think it's worth $5,000, come up here, I'll sell it to you right now. But how much is achieving your dreams worth to you financially? If you said, Steve, I can put $100,000 a month in your pocket for a $5,000 investment. My first question is, anybody, what would be your first question?
Is it legal?
Is it legal? I hadn't thought of that question. That's a good one. My first question is, will you guarantee it? Will you guarantee you can do that for me? Because here's what I found. How about you? I'm going to go back and tell you. Is it okay if I share part of my story with you?
Yes.
Go back 10 years. 10 years ago, actually 12, 14 years ago, I was fed up. I was sick to death of my life. Now, I owned a real estate appraisal company that somebody was giving away an appraisal. Right. I owned a real estate appraisal company with three employees, so there was five of us all together, right, in the business, three employees, one office person, and myself, doing pretty well, okay? And I owned a nightclub banquet hall. I was working 80 hours a week minimum. And you know what? I was like, man, I'm tired of doing this. Now, I loved it. If you ask me to open up a bar, a nightclub again, I'm there. I loved it. It was great. But it was wearing me out. You know, 10 years ago, 12 years ago, I was 60. I was 60 years old. Most 60-year-olds don't ever want to work 80 hours, 90 hours a week. Especially when you had to load the tables and do the things and move the chair. You know what? I did it, but I was tired of it. So I made a decision. I made a decision that everybody else probably in this room made. I don't know if you made it 10 years ago or last year, which was, I'm going to get online and make myself a fortune. Anybody else? And I went out 10 years ago and started buying $100 programs, $1,000 programs, $5,000 programs, and boom, nothing happened. All of you promised to make me thousandaires and then 100,000aires and now millionaires, and none of that worked, none of it. How about you guys? Anybody else share that? And then 5 years ago, I had the wonderful experience of actually having an awakening, a revelation, while I was working with someone. And in that fifth year, my life changed. And I learned what it took to be successful in that realm. I learned how to achieve, and that's the reason I put together my new program called Achieve. Right? It's all about achieving success, achieving your dreams, of achieving what you want to achieve. Who wants to achieve more? Okay? Question for you. How many people here have an extra $1,000? Look, nobody's hand goes up. Nobody's. $1,000? Nobody has $1,000? You know, 20 years ago, I didn't have $1,200, but today. Well, here's what I want you to know. If you told me you had an extra $1,000, I'd say, I don't want to work with you. Hmm. Right? Because if you have an extra $1,000, you don't care about that $1,000. Just an extra. I'll throw it over here. I'll buy that. I'll do this. I had a friend about 5 years ago. He was making so much money that when we were out to dinner, we got into this conversation about Bitcoin. And he said, oh, I just bought $10,000 worth of Bitcoin 5 years ago. And everybody's like, oh my gosh, what if it fails? And he goes, it's just $10,000. Just $10,000. You see, if that's the way you treat $1,000, then we can't do business properly. Because I'm looking for somebody who thinks enough of their money that if they're going to invest $1,000 with me for my program, that they're going to go, man, I believe in you, Steve, because I'm investing $1,000 in you and my growth. How many people would love to have that kind of investment? Okay? That's what this is all about. How we can help each other grow. Would you like to know the top three reasons most of us don't have any growth? How we haven't achieved our dreams? We'll go back to fear. Fear. Fear of stepping out. Fear of being proven wrong. How many times have you said something, I'm going to do this, and then you didn't do it? Lots of times. Right? Then there's the fear of not accomplishing. I put my goals down, I wrote them down. I got them right here, and then I didn't achieve them. For me, I put down about every 6 months, I'm gonna lose 20 pounds. And at the end of that 6 months, I put down, I'm gonna lose 20 pounds. Now, do I feel bad about not achieving my dream? Absolutely, every time I get on the scale, I go, why'd you eat that last donut, Steve? Why? And then people will say to me, how'd you do on your diet? Shut up. I don't want to talk about it. You see, we also abuse ourselves when it comes to setting our goals. Stop abusing yourself. And here's what I found was the secret to success. Are you ready for one or two of the secrets to success? accountability. The reason all of these freaking online programs have not worked for you, I can pull up my phone and show you that I saw one today where the person said, hey, I can make you a millionaire as a speaker. I can make you a millionaire as a course builder. I can make you. No, you can't. Because unless you have the personal involved, that's what I give to what I train and teach you to do, the personal. You and I will work for 3 months together. 3 months, 12 weeks of learning how to do wonderful things with me keeping you accountable, me teaching you programs. Matter of fact, I wrote this down because I know I forget. Here's what my program will offer in 12 weeks. Focus, direction, and attention to your goals. Accountability that we could not get from any online or uninterested guru. They don't care about you. Oh, here's my videos. Here's my course. Go for it. And they'll say, we give you a 100% money back guarantee. Isn't that what they say? You ever tried to get one? They go, well, you didn't write to us on week 20. Therefore, you nullified the guarantee. Gee, thanks. Right? The right tools coupled with personal instruction on how to use them. Somebody was in here talking about Instagram, right? Somebody says, hey, Steve, here's Instagram. That's a great tool. But if they didn't teach me how to use it, guess what? Doesn't matter. It's of no value to me. Real world hands-on sales training. One of the greatest challenges you will have in everything you're doing is that you use the wrong wording when you went to close your sale. How many people would like to close more sales? How much would it be worth to close one more sale? Right? Effective LinkedIn training to include creator mode. How many people even knew there was a creator mode on LinkedIn? Right? A couple? Almost nobody. Creator mode will enhance your LinkedIn. If you didn't know that, guess what? That alone could put more than $1,000 in your pocket. Website ideas and insights. Somebody here was talking about websites earlier. Guess what? If you don't know what to put on your website so that people stop and pause and take more than that 7 seconds, write your website off. Get your money back. It's of no value to you. Landing pages are much more valuable anyway. Training on how to get a lot more leads and appointments. Who would like more appointments every single month? Raise your hand if you would. Right? I will train you how to make that happen. I will also send you the ebook. This one's for you. Nobody can buy that ebook. You only get it when you do business with me. I'll send you the ebook because we've always heard, this one's for you, right? Rocky's in his little corner, and when he won, he went, yo, Adrian. Isn't that right? He was doing it for Adrian. No, do it for you, and everybody else will benefit from it. You can also be a guest on my podcast, The Happiness Agenda or the Speaker Talks podcast. Either one, you get to choose. But most importantly, if you buy, it's a $3,000 program for 12 weeks. But the most important part of this is you'll be getting my speaker talks event. Instead of $2,500, it will be $997. And that will include the most impactful audience engagement tool that you will ever find called storytelling. Who would like to have more audience engagement? How many people here have seen a boring speaker? How many people here don't want to think it's you? Guess what? It's probably you. I've had people tell me, they go, Steve, you don't understand. Nobody ever tells me I'm boring. I go, why would they? Do I walk up to you after you talk and go, holy crap, you suck? No. What do I say to you after you're done, no matter what? Good job. Good job. Hey, nice job. What?
That was great.
That was great. So what do you expect these boring people to understand? That they were bad? No, everybody comes around going, yeah. But guess what? When the last time you videotaped yourself, videotape, is that old? Recorded yourself. Last time you recorded yourself doing a talk, a speech, or a meeting, record yourself and watch it. I guarantee you, most of you will find yourself boring. You want to stop boring speakers, you can go to my website, Stop Boring Speakers. But what I want you to understand is, I will be glad to work with you for 3 months. You can reach out to me, and I will be there for you. My name is Steve Sapato, stevesapatoseminars.com. Okay? Any questions, reach out to me. I'll be here for you. God bless.
Yeah.